Okay, we arrived at Desoto Stae Park in Alabama, and we're here at the country store area where you're supposed to register for campsites, but they're closed today, and there's a phone number to call as an option. But however, we have no cellular coverage, so we're gonna try to get up to our campsite and maybe head down to the lodge and register there, because it gives you an option to go there. So we're gonna try to make it to our campsite and go from there. Okay, so we got into our reservation and got our gate code and proceeding to our campsite. We have reserved campsite number 30. We have never been to this park, so let's see what is in store for us.
You're watching Two for the Road
with Joe and Tammy, so join us for this adventure. This is the general store where you would normally check in. Some of the activities here at Desoto Park includes zip lining.
Here at Desoto Park, there's many hiking trails with beautiful boulders landscaping throughout the scenic trail. This trail also has an awesome boardwalk and has a pavilion with picnic tables and benches along the route. Boardwalk trail leads you to a cascading waterfall. We continued our hike to Indian Falls, which was a little bit more impressive than Azalea Cascading Falls. Just a short hike further, you then reach Lodge Falls. distance from the waterfalls, you have reached Little River.
Here are some of the views of the campground and campsites. Desoto Park has 94 campsites to choose from. It also has 21 primitive campsites to choose from. The campsites had electric, water, and sewer hookup. There was also a separate dump station for your convenience. Show you one of the coolest pull-through sites. It's 12 and 13 pull-through joined together, so it serves as like a buddy site. I thought this was a really cool pull-through, and I definitely wanted to get this into the video to share with you guys. So it accommodates two campers, and they both have their own grill, their own water, own electric and sewer hookup, but they share the same lane. I thought this was really cool to share with you guys. They got their own picnic tables, you know, which you can move them together and whatnot, but it has only one fire pit. And then right next door is another campsite. So if you had a third buddy that needed to come, you could park right next to you. I also wanted to mention that Tammy and I practically had the park to ourselves. There was only us and three other campers.
Dinner's ready.
While visiting Desoto State Park, which is located in Fort Payne, Alabama, today we're downtown Fort Payne, and as you can see, I'm wearing my Bengals hat, so that tells you I was rooting for the Bengals for the Super Bowl. But by chance, got a treat for you. The town is decorated a lot for one of their proud members of the Bengals that lived here in town. Take a look at that. Evan McPherson. Of course, the wind's not doing too well, but they got banners and stuff all over town here. I'm gonna do some shots of it as we walk through the town to show you the pride they have for this young fella. So anyway, we're gonna tour the town and visit some shops. Everywhere you go, you see Evan McPherson's banners. Here's one of the attractions you can do right while you're here in town. Axe throwing. Look at that. Look how the town's supporting this guy. Look, even on the door. Go Evan.
Here's another one.
And a poster of him.
McPherson. Even Elvis is a big fan. McPherson fan club.
Sorry about the wind, but you've got an old downtown theater that's still in operation. Look at that. Adults. 20 cents, children 10 cents for a movie. Ain't that something? And here we go is a monument for the boys from Fort Payne, Country Music Hall of Fame inductees. Got Jerry Allen Cook, Randy Yulin Owen, Mark Joel Herndon, and Teddy Wayne Gentry.
He's the only name I know.
Yep. That's pretty cool.
So here's the original train station for Fort Payne. And this is where and how this town was created. You know, because Fort Payne was not too far from here, and of course soldiers were and supplies were dropped off here. So I don't know if it's open. We're gonna check it out, see if it is. So here's the front side of it. The museum is actually closed, but here's an old caboose that Southern Pacific used in this area. As you can see, the tracks that are behind the museum is actually still active. It's operated by Union Pacific and Norfolk Southern. So here's something a little unique. One of the old trees still standing here in town. It is filled with old chandeliers. They'll see that every day.